As a lot of you guys know, neutering or spaying your dog, especially when they're younger, has a lot of health benefits in the future. So tomorrow, Booker is getting neutered, and I'm actually pretty nervous because it's his first, you know, real operation. You know, he's getting put to sleep tomorrow, and you know, the whole recovery process after getting neutered, he's probably gonna be kinda out of it. He's gonna be down, he's gonna be upset.
He doesn't care about the dog. Oh,
there's his best friend, I think.
Yeah.
He has a crush on her.
Yep, it's a girl. I think he wants to marry her. I think a good fun day before his, you know, sad day tomorrow. All right, guys, it's time. The vet just called. Booker is done with his surgery. He is ready to be picked up. They said he's very sleepy. They said he's very out of it. I miss Booker. I can't wait to see him and start this recovery process where I'm gonna have to take very, very good close care of him for probably the next 2 weeks. I feel so bad. Like, I have a soft spot for dogs, and this was probably Booker's worst day of his life. Most painful day of his life, and I can't wait to go get him and just, you know, kiss him and pet him and hug him. And I know I gotta be gentle because of the stitches and the surgery, but he's getting a million kisses for sure. Uh-oh, I'm walking in. Time to pick him up. I'm here to pick up Booker. He got neutered this morning.
Okay.
The instructions for how to take care of him after this. And all the medicine. Guys, I bought Booker a more comfortable recovery cone, whatever, for after his surgery, but it says you have to blow it up yourself.
Yeah, you think they're gonna do that for you?
I paid for the surgery.
Right. You're about to pass out.
Anything for my dog.
Oh my
baby.
Oh my
goodness.
Hi, my love. Hey, no jumping.
Hey,
come down.
Hey.
Come down.
Oh, hey, you're not supposed to be jumping around.
Okay.
Here.
Oh
no,
my God.
No. So, this is why you're paying. Did you read the memo?
Okay, Booker. Oh my goodness, Booker. You just got surgery. Yo, I don't know how, but Booker is full of energy right now, and it makes no sense. Even the vet was in shock. Booker, do you know what just happened to you today or no? Okay, don't jump. No jumping. No jumping. No, 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 no. They said he's not supposed to be like this. So he needs to take his medication. It's bad because he has stitches. So if he keeps jumping and running and going crazy, the stitches could pop open.
Hey.
Booker, are you walking yourself? Let me see your mouth, Booker.
You see how he did that?
Booker.
No, 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 no running. No running.
Look, he holds the leash himself.
He's so sad.
He's so young. Like, Booker, you don't realize you just had, like, your biggest surgery of your life today?
6.5 hours later.
So Booker just took his meds. You know what he's gonna be right now? Guys, I think Booker finally fell asleep. I don't want to wake him up because he's probably in so much pain. So since Booker wasn't allowed to eat all day because of the surgery, they told us we should feed him at 8 p.m. because he needs to eat today. It's 8:11 right now, so we were trying to wake him up so he could eat, but the medication is so strong. He's literally like, wait, look at his little paws. He literally won't wake up. Like, he'll just open his eyes and then go back to sleep.
I'm gonna mention how his cone is a luxury cone. He's going on a flight to Arizona to see Dennis.
I'm trying to wake him up so he could eat, but he's so, like, out of it that he can't even keep his eyes open for more than 10 seconds. But we're supposed to feed him. I don't know what to do. I don't know if you could tell, but, like, his little eyes are open. Buddy, you gotta eat. You haven't ate since yesterday. It's been, like, 24 hours. Oh, Booker, you're alive. I feel so bad. He looks so sad. We've never seen Booker like this. We're used to Booker being crazy, jumping, playful.
I mean,
okay, when he was asleep, that was different. But now when I see him with his eyes open and he's awake, but he still can't move, that's what's sad.
All right, guys, so I'm gonna try to put Booker food and take it up to him upstairs.
over 24 hours since the last time he ate, and the vet told us to make sure he eats around 8 p.m. And guys, this is all new to me. I've never been around a dog who just got neutered. Bosley, who I've had for 5 years now, was not neutered because growing up as a puppy, Bosley was never able to be put to sleep because he was always on some type of medication or he was always just too sick. So I've never been around a puppy who just got neutered. So this is all new to me. Let's look at the guide. Feed Booker half the amount of food and water. Oh, he needs to drink water too. We're gonna put some warm water on the food so that it's easier for him to chew it. Yes, my dog is spoiled, but he just had surgery, so leave him alone. I'm trying my best to take care of Booker, so everything is so new to me, but I'm trying my best, and I hope I'm doing a good job. Booker, we're coming with some food. Booker, you wanna eat a little bit? We'll take the pillow off you while you eat.
He just tried to jump from the couch to eat and he can't.
So like he tried to get up and he literally just fell to his side. I don't know if he's gonna be able to stand like to eat.
No, you're gonna have to like help him. Just let him lay.
I guess that's what they mean when they say your dog is gonna be drugged up for like the next 3 days.
I really think he likes that pillow thing. Look.
I think he just can't freaking do anything to take it off if he wanted to. Okay guys, so I guess we're just gonna let him sleep the medicine off. Hopefully it doesn't last too long because like I said, he needs to eat right now. It's been a... Guys, he looks like he's in so much pain. Did you see? He can't even stand up. He literally fell to his side.
I know, I was crying when you went downstairs. It was so sad.
I don't like seeing this, but... It is almost 10:30 right now, and Booker still can't get up, but his eyes have been open for a really long time. He just can't get up because he has to eat. So I'm just feeding him with my hand, and as you could tell, he's starving. Look, every single piece that goes in front of him, watch. He's starving. I hope the medicine wears off soon because he needs to go pee. Guys, I'm usually not even at this house this late because I don't sleep here. And I usually leave before 10:30, way before 10:30. So this feels, I'm not gonna lie, it feels a little scary and I'm starting to get like, I'm just starting to get weird vibes. And then Jackie is about to leave. She has to go home. So I called my mom and I told her that I'm gonna come spend the night over there because it's hard to take care of him by myself and I don't know in the middle of the night in case he wakes up and starts biting at his stitches. Oh, Booker. I got you. So I need some help watching him throughout the night and my mom is so happy that I'm sleeping over there. She's like, oh my gosh, like the old days. So my mom's super happy. I'm gonna spend the night over there. And I was supposed to leave here much sooner, but I didn't think Booker was still gonna be so out of it this late.
No, we've been hearing stuff. Brandon's like, okay, the vibe is getting weird, let's leave.
Guys, imagine, the vibe started getting weird, and then we started hearing stuff like from one of the rooms, and then Jackie has to go home. Mm-hmm. So I'm just like, Booker, your medicine better wear off because we gotta go to my mom's house.
I'm sorry, baby. Not you, Booker. Just so everybody doesn't call me. Oh my God. At whatever minute, Jackie called him baby. Oh.
Guys, so Jackie just left to go home. And I ended up carrying Booker down here to the backyard so that he could pee. But he's pretty unresponsive right now. But it's getting pretty late. So after Booker pees, whenever that is, I'm just going to go straight to my mom's house. She's really, really excited to have me sleep over today. And I'm excited because I know my mom and my brother and my dad are going to help me take care of Booker. And also a huge shout out to Jackie for helping me today too. She had to go home. Her mom wanted her home. But before that, she helped me out so much today. So shout out to Jackie. Thank you. And hopefully Booker pees soon because I'm not trying to be at this house this late. What the hell? Hold on. Guys, what the hell? Someone just ran here, dropped fireworks in the middle of the street, and then left. Look. Man, some people are like literally stupid. Like, you get entertainment from coming to my house this late, putting fireworks in the middle of the street and running. Congratulations. Wow. Wow, what a show. It feels like 4th of July. I wish the person who did it was man enough to stay instead of run away. All right, so let's see what this was all about last night. I'm telling you guys, it was getting really late. I was getting ready to take my dog and go to my parents' house. And some haters decided to drop some fireworks off in the middle of the street that I live on. Exclusive. Caution. Nice. Like, when you guys watch this video, the people that dropped this off, can I just ask how cool do you guys feel? Or how empowered do you guys feel that you guys were able to disrupt the middle of my night? But I'm telling you guys, Broad Squad, everybody watching this, the funniest part to me is not dropping the fireworks off and watching them explode. The funniest part to me is how these people drop them off and then they run away. Go, go, go. I don't want Brandon to see us. I don't want Brandon to come out. That's the funniest part to me. You know, if you think you're like, you know, brave enough to leave fireworks in the middle of the street and, you know, stop me from going to my mom and dad's house, then why aren't you brave enough to stand right in front of the house? Or why aren't you brave enough to come up to the door and leave the fireworks right here? Why not? It's the, all right, bro, leave the fireworks. Go, go, go. Brandon's gonna see us. Brandon's gonna see us. Run, run, run. That's the funny part to me. This is what you guys were bothering when you set off the fireworks, this right here. So this little dude has never heard fireworks before in his life. So imagine what he felt. He had just got out of surgery. He was under medication. He was awake, but he couldn't move. And he heard fireworks exploding for the first time in his life. I didn't even want to show him in the video because it was so sad when the fireworks were going off. I don't care about myself. I'm a grown man. I don't get scared of fireworks, like whatever. But my 6-month-old puppy who just had his first surgery, he had just got home from the vet. It was his first night trying to sleep under all this medication. Has never heard fireworks or reacted to fireworks in his life. You guys, people who set those fireworks off, I hope you don't have a dog of your own and I hope you don't love animals, because you guys should have seen Booker yesterday. It was the saddest thing I've seen and I didn't even want to show it in the video. So congrats to you guys. You know, if you were trying to mess with my dog, then perfect. If you were trying to mess with me, it didn't work, but you guys messed with a dog who just got out of surgery, a little puppy, a 6-month-old puppy. I don't know, guys, but hey, thank you guys for the free show though, because I'm, you know, growing up, I never used to buy fireworks or play with fireworks. My mom used to make me wait till 4th of July. I only got to see fireworks once a year growing up, and all my friends used to buy these fireworks and, you know, oh, let's go to the park and set these off, and my mom would be like, no, Brandon, you're gonna get in trouble. That's dangerous. So I never got to see those. So thank you guys for the people who dropped them off in the middle of my street. You guys gave me 4th of July 2 times in 1 year. I never had that growing up, so thank you guys. Guys, but what pisses me off most about these kids or adults, I don't even know what they were, these haters that dropped the fireworks off on my street, it's not that, you know, anything with me. You know, I could care less. People do stuff to my house and to my car and to my family all the time. They do stuff. You know, I'm used to it. It's some fireworks in the middle of the street, big deal, whatever. I don't even spend the night here, so I was just chilling. What pisses me off, there's kids that live on the street. I'm talking like, you know, 5 years old, 6 years old. They got school the next day. You're telling me some 5-year-old kid, kindergarten, first grade, you're telling me they're not gonna wake up and get scared from, you know, explosives, fireworks in the middle of the street? They will. That's what pisses me off. There's little kids all over this street. Not just that, but there's elderly. There's people that live on the street that I know that are 70, 80 years old. You know, some of the nicest people I know in my life. Some of the nicest people I've ever met. You know, 80 years old, trying to go to sleep at midnight. And you're over here, you know, dropping fireworks off. And like I said, to me, I don't care. You know, I'm awake, but to other, like, you know, the kids, the babies on this street, and not to mention, you know, the older people, it's just, that's why these haters don't think. They drop these fireworks off. Oh, let's see what happens to Brandon. Oh, is Brandon gonna get mad? Oh, is Brandon gonna be disrupted? Okay, cool, think about me, but you don't think about all the other families and all the other people that live on the street. Whatever, guys, maybe I was just raised differently than these people. Mom, you did a good job raising me and Brian. Dad, you did a good job raising me and Brian. Thank you. I love you guys, because we would never do anything stupid like this. Yeah, I
can never ever find the right words. And there's no way this is real life. There's no telling you're the right girl. So I can only say that it feels right.